Good morning, Wildcats, and welcome to today's edition of Wildcat News. Today is Tuesday, October 17th, and on this episode, we've got brand new trivia question and much more. That's all coming right up, but first, please stand for the flag salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
First up, let's kick it off with today's broadcast with a little bit of trivia. Did you know that today is National Pasta Day? In honor of that, today's trivia question is...
If you know the correct answer, email it to Ms. Lyons at klyons@msemail.org. to possibly win a prize. Winners and answers will be announced on tomorrow's show.
Over the weekend, each class in the senior high decorated their halls for Spirit Week. Let's check out the results.
And the bass keeps running, running, and 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 running, running, and
in this context, there's no disrespect, so when I bust my rhyme, you break your neck. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. To lose our inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl is pulling me out, you wouldn't believe how we wow. We burn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from northwest, east side. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked, come on, get it started, come on, get it started, get it started. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Ha. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Ha. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Ha. Let's get it started in here. Yeah.
Lose control, a body and soul. Don't move too fast, people just take it slow.
Teachers and staff, don't forget to vote for the best decorated hallway using Google Form Miss Polina sent out.
Student Equity Council is back. If you would like to join the club that allows you to have a voice around the school, the first meeting of the year will be on Wednesday, October 18th at 2:30 in C41. All 7th to 12th graders are welcome to attend. See Ms. Newman or Ms. Morgan with any questions.
The interest meeting for the Junior High Battle of the Books Club is today, after school in the library. Any 7th or 8th graders interested in learning more about the club are invited to attend.
The Junior High Science Club meets Thursday after school in room E22.
And the Junior High Art Club meets this Thursday, October 19th, after school in room B21. The club is open to all 7th and 8th graders, but you must sign up to attend since space is limited to 25 spots.
What's on the menu to lunch? Let's go to Karis.
Your choices today for lunch are a walking taco, seasoned brown rice, chicken tenders, or beef chili. Back to you guys in the studio.
You may have noticed some of the cheerleaders stationed outside of the cafeteria during lunch and learn. For every $1 they collect, they will have to do that many push-ups during halftime at the homecoming game. A portion of the proceeds raised will go to breast cancer research, donate to your favorite cheerleader's jar, and help support a great cause.
National Art Honor Society is holding a Halloween event in the gym on Thursday, October 26th from 6 to 9 p.m. There will be lots of fall activities such as pumpkin painting, face painting, and much more. All are invited to attend. See Ms. Braverman with any questions.
What's happening with our fall sports today? Here's Karis with your Wildcat sports update.
Tonight at 6 p.m., the boys' soccer team has their senior night game at home against New Egypt. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Karis.
Also in Wildcat sports, varsity boys cross country captured the Freedom Division title last Tuesday. Way to go.
The middle school field hockey team lost to Bordentown on Thursday, but shout out to Nyana for many fantastic saves.
And some updates from this past weekend. While the varsity football team lost their game against Clayton on Friday night, some of the highlights included Jerrion's beautiful catch from Jason at the end of the first half. And then with 2 minutes and 55 seconds left in the third quarter, Jason's touchdown pass to Ryan. They'll look to bounce back at Saturday's Pink Out homecoming game.
And on Saturday, boys soccer beat Penn Tech 3-0.
This game features standout performances from many on the team. Felipe scored 2 goals and MJ scored 1, assist by Jeremiah, Vitor, and Juan. Shout out to the player of the match, Eli Hernandez, for a rock-solid performance in the center of defense. Great job, guys.
Finally, we'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Nazifa Chowdhury.
Well, that's all the news we have for you today.
And when the sun is out.